joy. So many blessings wait for you in store. So hold your head up high, for a new season is nigh. The best season of your life.
We yet believe that the best season of your life is just ahead.
God has so many things for you to enjoy. So many blessings wait for you in store. A new season is nigh, the best season of your life.
We yet believe that the best season of your life is just ahead.
A new season is nigh, the best season of your life.
And we yet believe that the best season of your life is just ahead.
A new season is nigh, the best season of your life. Life, the best season of your life is just ahead.
We yet believe that the best season of your life is just ahead.
Season of your life is just ahead.
Good evening, all who join us for our Thursday night fireside chat. We're so grateful to see each and every one of you, grateful as we continue to transition to in-person worship and continue to stream our worship experiences on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. and 12 noon. So glad to see those who have returned to in-person worship, and certainly understanding of those who are taking their time. But we praise God for your continued engagement, for your prayers, for your support, and for the confidence that you have placed in the leadership and staff of our congregation as we carefully and safely re-enter into worship. We want to continue to say to you, we ask that you would continue to stay safe, continue to do those things that will keep you safe and those around you safe as well, because we love you and we don't want anything adverse to happen to you. So please, if you will, stay safe. We recommend very highly that you try the vaccinations that are available to you all, to us as a community, and we praise God that we've been able to, as a church, partner with some of our community partners to make it available to those who are part of our congregation as well as our community. We praise God for the life of the Salem Church and those who are a part of members of our of the Salem Church and those who are our ministry partners that have become ministry partners over the course of the last 18 months. We are grateful for each and every one of you. We still have a lot going on in the life of the church. We want to remind you, on Saturday, October 30th, beginning at 10 a.m., we'll be having our drive-through harvest festival for 2021. We will have 500 bags of candy. And so please bring your children, your grandchildren, the children in your life through on Saturday, October 30th, beginning at 10 a.m. And we'll be giving them out until we run out of them. Now, someone said to me that whatever candy is left over, I have to eat. So I don't want any candy left over. So please, please bring your children out, and we're going to bless those in our community as well. That's, again, Saturday, October 30th, beginning at 10 a.m. On Saturday, November 6th, the deacons will be distributing communion elements from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. You can just drive through and get those elements to make sure that you have all that you need to share with us in communion, wherever you might be, even as we lead you in communion here from the sanctuary of the Salem Church. Again, that's Saturday, November 6th, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We also want to remind you that our Word for Your Walk broadcast is each Sunday on the CW network at 1:30 p.m. So please, please, if you will, encourage others to watch it as well. I was so blessed. I was at Citywide Revival at Mount Nebo the other night, and one of the persons in attendance, one of our seniors in our community, was in attendance, and she made her way to me after the benediction to make sure that I knew each Sunday she watched our broadcast. And so it's been a blessing to our community and to our church family as well. Again, we want to say thank you so much as we shared in the celebration of our 16th pastoral anniversary on last week. We thank you for the encouragement that you shared with me and my family, as well the generosity that you displayed. We are grateful. Salem, it is a pleasure and a privilege to seek to give pastoral leadership and to serve here at the Salem Church. Listen, 16 years and it has gone by, it has flown by. And as they say, time flies when you're having fun. And so we praise God for each of you that shared with us in that wonderful celebration. Each and every year, we share 2 months where we encourage the church to trust God with the tithe. They're all church tithe Sundays, Acts Sundays, all church tithe Sundays. We do it in April because of church anniversary, and we do it in November because it's the season of Thanksgiving. And a thankful giver we should be. We should be joyful givers. And so we're asking you to pray and to prepare throughout the month of November to trust God with the tithe, 10%, one-tenth of the resources that the Lord has given you. We know that we are managers and stewards of what the Lord has given us. All that we have comes from the Lord. And he asked us in his word to trust him with the tithe. And so again, November is all church tithes Sundays. And we're asking you to pray and to prepare to trust God with the tithe during the month of November. And we know if you begin to trust him with the tithe, then he will prove his word, that he will open the windows of heaven and pour us out blessings we won't have room enough to receive. Praise God. And we thank you for your continued giving, your continued stewardship of your finances as it relates to the Salem Church. We praise God for your faithfulness. And we remind you each time that we stream of the various platforms by which you're able to give your tithe and your offering. You can mail it to the church here at 3131 Lake Street, Omaha, Nebraska, 68111, from 9 to 5, Monday through Friday. You can bring it here to the church. There is a secure tithe and offering box just outside of the administrative offices. You can give through our website at salembc.org, through PayPal, through Venmo, through Cash App, through Givelify, and you can text to give at 402-543-3316. Again, that's 402-543-3316. Again, we thank you for your continued faithfulness and stewardship of what God has given to you. Amen. We're going to be very brief on tonight, but there is a text in Psalm, in the collection of the Psalms, in Psalm 62, verses 5 through 7. And it is a psalm that is penned and authored by David. You remember David, we've been preaching about David over the last few months, one of the greatest biblical characters that we have, and as well a great lyricist, a great writer. And so he penned this psalm, and he says three very remarkable things in verses 5 through 7 of Psalm 62. He says, first of all, the Lord is my help. The Lord is my help. Listen to what he says in verse 5. My soul waits silently for God alone, for my expectation is from him. Notice how he opens that verse. It's almost as if he's talking to himself, trying to strengthen his faith, trying to make sure that he will be patient as the Lord is working. He says, my soul waits silently for God alone. He's really saying to his soul, to himself, that there is only one that I need to wait on who can do something about my situation. He says he's speaking to himself, but then the text says that, goes on to say, for my expectation is from him. My soul wait silently for God alone, for my expectation is from him. Now that word expectation can be translated as well hope. It can be translated hope. So he's saying, for my hope is from the Lord. My hope is from the Lord. And child of God, all of us ought to have base our hope in the Lord. Because the truth is, when you cannot place your hope in anything or anyone else, we are able to confidently place our hope in the Lord. How many of us have been disappointed when we placed our hope in our job, when we placed our hope in our spouse or significant other, when we've placed our hope in other relationships, and even at times when we've placed our hopes in the church? Child of God, I want to let you know there is only one that will not disappoint you, and his name is Jesus. And we are reminded that he sticks closer than a brother. And so I want to challenge you, as David says, tell the world that the Lord is my hope when I cannot depend on anything else or anyone else. I know that I can confidently place my hope and my assurance in the Lord. And so David says, listen, the Lord is my hope. But then he says, he is my help. He is my help. And he says that in verse 62, Psalm 62, verse 6. And he goes on a list of descriptors of what the Lord is to him. And he comes to the conclusion that the Lord is my help. Listen to what he says in verse 6. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. So David says, the Lord is my help, first of all, because he's my foundation. David says, the Lord is my rock. He is my foundation. He is the one thing that I know when everything else is shaky, when everything else is uncertain. Listen, the Lord is the one thing that I can depend on. And so he says that the Lord is my foundation. The Lord is my foundation. And then he says, the Lord is my deliverer. He's my deliverer. He says, he only is my rock and my salvation. That word salvation really means, in this portion of the Word of God, that he is able to save me from something I'm not able to save myself from. And so David has a history of many things that he had experienced, but he had experienced the fact that the Lord was his deliverer, his salvation. When he was a young shepherd boy watching the flock of his father, he shared with King Saul that there was an occasion where a bear came to steal from the flock, another occasion that a lion came to steal from the flock. And on both occasions, the Lord delivered me. He was my salvation. In speaking with King Saul on that same occasion, he said, just as they were facing a giant, a 9-foot giant by the name of Goliath, that had sown fear in the armies of Israel. He went to King Saul and declared, I am able to face this giant. And just as he was my salvation with the lion and the bear, just as he was my deliverer on those occasions, he will deliver me from this giant Goliath. And he will do so because the battle is not mine, it is the Lord's. And all, child of God, I want to let you know, he's still a deliverer. He's still your salvation. He is still able to save you from the things you cannot save yourself from. And then David says, not only is he my foundation and my deliverer, he says he is my protector. He, in the text, he says, he alone is my rock, my foundation, and my salvation, my deliverer. He is my defense. That's what David says in the text. He's saying that he is my protector. Again, David has experience with this. That same King Saul that allowed him to face Goliath, the giant Goliath, that same Saul became jealous of David. Because the maidens were crying out, Saul has killed his thousands, but David has killed his 10,000s. He became envious and jealous of David. And as a result, he put a price on David's head. He sent assassins to seek to take David's life away from him. He, Saul himself, went on the attack trying to take David's life. And David's testimony was that the Lord was my defense. He protected me from King Saul, from his soldiers, from his assassins. He says, the Lord is my defense. And saints of God, I want to tell you on today, there's no one who can defend you like the Lord. There's no one who can protect you like the Lord. There is no one who can put his arms and a hedge of protection around you like the Lord. Listen, even when your enemies come against you, the Bible says that he can make your enemies your footstool. And so David says, yes, he is my hope. He is my help because he's my foundation. He's my deliverer. He's my protector. And as a result, David says, the Lord provides a sure foundation. He says in this text, he only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. Oh, thank God that when things around us, again, are shaky and uncertain, the Lord can allow us to stand steadily and stand sturdy because he is our foundation. We shall not be moved. And for those of us who live on this side of the cross, we're able to not be moved because we have the firm foundation of Jesus Christ. He is our rock. And so he says, he's my hope, he's my help. And he closes in verse 7 by saying, he is my haven. Listen to what he says in verse 7. In God is my salvation and my glory, the rock of my strength, and my refuge is in God. A haven is a refuge. A refuge is a haven. It is a shelter. It is a place where you're able to be protected from all of the elements from in the physical realm, but in the spiritual realm, it's a place where you can be protected from the spiritual elements that seek to take you out and burden you down. The place he is a place of refuge from guilt and shame and from sin and from the weakness and discouragement that seeks to take us out and to take us down. And we can run to that refuge. We can run to him when the world seems on attack against us. We have a refuge. A haven is a refuge. It's a shelter, but it's also a sanctuary. It's also a sanctuary. It is a place where we can go and be in peace and worship the God of our salvation. And we praise God that the Lord is our haven. And child of God, I want to say to you, when there's nowhere else for you to go, you ought to run to the refuge that's in our God. You ought to run to the shelter, to the sanctuary, the place that you can feel safe and secure, even when the storms of life are raging in your life. We thank God for David's reminding us in this text that he is our hope, he is our help, and he is our haven. Child of God, you can only run to him if you have a relationship with him. If you've trusted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and received the free gift of salvation through his death, burial, and his resurrection. Romans 10 reminds us, if you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that he died for the sins of the world, that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Oh, what a wonderful time it would be to right now trust him as Lord and Savior. And you can truly experience him as your hope and your help and as a haven and refuge to run to. I hope this word has been an encouragement to you on tonight. Let's pray. Lord, we love you and we thank you for your word. We thank you for the encouragement that you give us through your word as you remind us who you are to us through your word. Bless each and every person listening or watching in this moment, that it may give them strength and assurance, that it will give them what they need to move on into another day's journey. And now unto him who's able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his glory with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God be glory, dominion, and power, both now and forever. And the people of God said together, amen and amen. And we yet believe the best season of your life is just ahead.